when CMT Inside Fame returns.
Eyes before us as we go.
In 1988, Rodney Krall finally achieved stardom with his breakthrough album, Diamonds and Dirt, making country music history with 5 consecutive hit singles. While his career skyrocketed, his marriage to Roseanne Cash descended. The demands of success found him spending more time on the road, creating more marital discord. Adding to the pressure, Columbia insisted that he quickly release a follow-up album. In May of 1989, while recording Keys to the Highway, Rodney received an urgent phone call.
We got a call on the road that his father had had a massive heart attack, and we jumped on a plane together and flew down to Houston.
Members of the family gathered at a Houston hospital awaiting the inevitable. Rodney knew he needed to make peace with his dying father.
It was like watching someone work through the last and hardest bits of what they came here to do. And a lot of it was with Rodney, he and Rodney together.
An angry young man and a sweet man at the end of his life. And just those last days of his life, we just spent cuddled up in bed. You know, and he literally died in mine and my cousin Larry Willoughby's arms.
Still grieving for his father, Rodney returned to the studio to finish his album with new songs reflecting his loss.
Now I don't have to hang my head over things I wish I'd said.
We cut this song, and he broke down just on the board and just broke down, and we all did. Just
a bunch of grown guys, you know, with headphones crying.
Keys to the Highway was rushed to record stores in the fall of 1989. Unlike Diamonds and Dirt, the album produced no hits and meager sales. Columbia was extremely disappointed.
I wasn't disappointed with the sales. I was disappointed with myself for letting it go before it was finished.
And I think that was a turning point where he decided that this is not fun. So he just sort of turned his back on trying to be mainstream.
In addition to his professional problems, Rodney's personal upheaval was intensifying as he and Roseanne were growing further apart, unable to resolve their marital conflicts. In 1990, Roseanne documented the disintegration of the relationship in her revealing album entitled Interiors. The public discovered that the perfect couple seemed headed for divorce.
On the surface, everything's okay.
Was I going to excuse myself from this commitment? And I decided, no, I'll stay in and make it work. And when I made that decision, she said, you know, I'm out of here.
We had just got to this point where we couldn't grow together anymore. We were like, you know, it was just abrasion at this point.
When the day finally arrived for the court hearing, the end of the storybook relationship came without anger or bitterness.
When we went to get divorced, we went into the judge's office holding hands. And we went home and had sex. So it wasn't that bad. I've never told anyone that, and I don't know if he has either, but it just seemed like we had to. We'd been together for so long, you know? It's like you can't just end this kind of relationship on a handshake.
Because it was time to move on, and we both knew it.
Hardly know how to be myself anymore.
After the divorce, Rodney recorded what would be his last album for Columbia, the appropriately entitled Life is Messy. The album was his reply to Roseanne's Interiors album.
Life is messy. It makes you feel like Elvis Presley.
Life is Messy was, we all went, we know what that's about. And Interiors, we all went, we know what that's about. It was just sort of sitting back going, yikes.
If you put Interiors and Life is Messy side by side, I think that Roseanne was much more the courageous artist at that time because she made hers completely about, and maybe that's the difference in a man and a woman, you know, she made it completely about the sorrow and the soul searching, and I only went there to a certain degree, and then I had to paint this little pleasant picture occasionally that now I don't enjoy.
We've been loving all night, just about sending me everything right, hoping on Benny.
The pleasant picture he painted in his song Loving All Night would provide the setting for Rodney to meet a new love, Claudia Church.
Hanging on tight, no doubt about it, been
we set about to cast the characters for the video, and we picked this woman from Atlanta to come and play the kind of the lead. It was a flirty love interest, kind of kissing and, you know, very flirty video.
The girl that was playing the love interest in the video had been hired from Atlanta, and she drove up, and she had just walked in the door, and she was supposed to be there at 1 o'clock.
With the lead actress 2 hours late and still not in makeup, the producer, in desperation, asked an eager extra to be the replacement.
You have your makeup on. Can you just put this outfit on and immediately start shooting? And I said, well, yeah, sure. She said, well, you know, this is a kissing thing, so, and she was like, but you've done lots of kissing. This is no problem.
I don't want to, you know, be too invasive here. I said, but I'm going to plant one on you anyway, you know, to make it look real. She said, oh, okay. And it was like, you know, it's like that was how that got my attention. I went, oh, my goodness.
Both of us kind of had this strange connection that was like we'd known each other for 20 years.
I said, look, I'm just smitten with you. I said, this is just at first sight for me. I said, and I have to say this.
While Rodney's relationship with Claudia Church evolved, his relationship with Columbia Records ended in 1993 due to artistic differences and a lack of sales for the follow-up albums to Diamonds and Dirt. But Rodney wasn't without a record deal for long. That same year, old friend Tony Brown, now president of MCA Records, signed Rodney.
It was the biggest deal we ever did there in my 17 years on an artist that had not had but one gold record. It was a huge deal, but to me it was worth it. I mean, I was going, now I can get Rodney back on track.
Coming up, Rodney risks everything for the sake of his art.
After all these years, this is what I've come to. I'm like bankrupt myself making my own music.
When CMT Inside Fame continues.